Quack, quack, gamers. What's up? Welcome back to Yentrok Gaming. Today, we're going to be taking a little look at a game called Duck Detective, The Secret Salami. Let's read the synopsis here. It says, solving crime is no walk in the pond. You are a down-on-his-luck detective who also happens to be a duck. Use your powers of deduction to inspect evidence, fill in the blanks, and bust the case wide open. This is a short but twisty detective case. All right, this one should be a good time. I'm excited to play this one. Let's get started. All right, let's get started here. New game. Would you like dialogue to auto-advance? No, I don't think so, because I want to click for the next dialogue, right? Let's see, detective mode recommended. Feel like a true detective, less information provided when incorrect. Story mode, a smoother experience for fledgling detectives, more information provided when incorrect. Okay, this decision can be changed later in the options menu, so let's just do the recommended one for now and we'll change it if we need to.
Life wasn't easy.
Oh, so this is gonna be like a film noir kind of thing? I love it already, this is very cute.
I was a freshly divorced duck, not able to pay next month's rent.
Aww.
Not that I had paid for it this month yet. My brain felt foggy, and I was trying to remember, where did all my money go?
To the little ducklings, didn't it?
I had to retrace last night's steps.
Deductions. Deductions are a vital part of a detective's work. Find clue words by questioning your persons and inspecting your surroundings. Enter clue words into the blank spaces to solve deductions. Okay. The nest egg. So we're looking for someone who spent his or her last money on blank for blank. So, rent. Okay, let's not worry about it. Let's start and let's ask some questions, I guess. So can we click on any of these things?
I won't be needing this badge anymore.
Oh.
I guess I can keep it as a suit. My new job as the duck detective isn't going any better, though.
Duck detective added two clues. Okay.
Well, if things keep going badly, I could always sell it online.
Okay, so all of these little things here we can look at. Nice.
No messages. This fresh smell. Oh, sweet spongy loaf. Oh, you keep me safe at night.
That's a little creepy.
This fresh.
Okay, he just says the same thing. I was wondering if it still, because the chair one went away, but this one popped back up. I was wondering if it would say something different.
I took that photo of her in a secluded tulip field.
Ooh.
We spoke for hours under the stars that night.
Did you now?
And now, she doesn't even answer my texts.
Oh, poor guy. What's this?
I can't believe Anna actually filed the divorce papers. Second overdue notice.
Aww.
I wonder at what point they start kicking people out.
Not much longer.
I have everything I need to solve this now.
Oh. Okay. Well, let's take a look here. So, where's the rest of my words at? Like, I want to see, duck detective. bread. The duck detective spent his or her last money on bread for the duck detective.
Not my proudest moment. But the toast helps me to forget.
Oh, you got this, buddy. Here, come get answer your phone.
I haven't had a slice of bread in weeks.
Like yesterday.
You have to believe me!
Oh, no.
Oh. Yeah, you're speaking to me.
It's not Anna.
Let's discuss this in person. Now, be there in an hour.
That's very cute. I like it.
Of my remaining cash on the bus fare, and here I was in front of Bear Bus Office, some sort of rundown call center. I better crack this case, or I won't even have enough money to make it back home.
This kind of reminds me of Later Alligator, which I played not too long ago. It's got the same kind of feel to it.
New bus route starting in August. Visit the scenic mountains of Salsiccia.
Salsiccia.
I'd always tell Anna we'd go there one day.
Yeah. Still time. Let's see what's over here. Hey, who are you?
I'm staying here until I get my money back.
Oh.
Bear bus? More like scam bus.
What are you talking about?
Sound unhappy.
You bet I am! Their stupid buses always arrive late!
Okay.
I came back from a work trip to the West and arrived here at 3 in the morning!
Yikes.
And they don't even want to give me a refund.
How much did you pay?
Two schmark. But that's not the point! It's about the principal.
Okay. I'm wondering what all these things are. Maybe we'll get into that a little bit later. Can we go behind? Nothing in here. Can we go back here? Nothing back here. Look at this guy. He's kind of scary looking. Can we go over there right now, or do we have to go in the bus office first? Hello? All right, we'll go inside. Maybe.
I could already tell based on her face that the receptionist was a tough one. She wouldn't make life easy for me. But I had to make my way into the office. I'm the duck detective. I'm here to investigate a case.
Okay. Do you work here?
I am at the moment. I am
no.
Working.
Well, then I can't let you in.
But I've been hired by someone from Bear Bus.
Who hired you?
Mr. Bear.
I didn't catch their name.
Listen, buddy. You better get out of here, or I'll have to call security.
There's always more to people than you might think. I should take a closer look and figure out what she's about.
Okay. She's about cats. Inspection. Use the magnifying glass to find clues and press E to uncover them. Okay. Oh, she's crying. Okay, we got her name. All right. Was that it, or did she have some more? I mean, we found three. I just want to make sure. Okay. So then, can we talk to her again?
You're still here?
Yeah.
I'll leave you alone.
Okay, we're gonna look at... Ooh. Mug? Stolen? If someone steals my mug again, I'll end them. Oh boy. Well, that's quite a suggestion. I don't know how that's gonna play out. It's Sophie's birthday next Thursday. Just saying. Okay, Sophie, we'll get you a gift. Laura from CS is way too loud. I can hear her keyboard all the way to my desk.
These are quite mundane.
Not good suggestions?
I'm surprised nobody wrote something more scandalous.
It's important to work out a suspect's name to crack the case. Okay. Enter their first and last name into the slots below their portrait in your journal suspect page. Okay. So, I know this one. Her last name was this. I don't know if it's Laura or Sophie, though. Should I know? Sophie's birthday next Thursday, just saying. Laura from customer service. I guess maybe it's Laura because she's customer.
I should be able to deduce her name.
Customer
now.
Service? So let's say it's Laura. It's not Laura. Okay. Not sure how I was supposed to know that. I just figured she was customer service because she's at the front desk. All right, let's check out the calendar. Uh-oh. Somebody knocked that over. Cute giraffe. Aww. Smiley face. September. Wake me up when September ends. September 7th. That's today. No birthdays on here anywhere? All right.
Tomorrow is Friday. Need to remember to collect my dry cleaning. I should be able to figure out what's going on with her.
Okay.
I need to check my notes in the deduction section.
Okay, let's see. Sophie is feeling sad because people. Hang on, let's look at this. Okay. Because nobody has remembered her birthday.
That's why she's making such a face.
Give her a cake.
I should try and cheer her up.
Yeah. Happy birthday!
You're still here?
I'm just here to wish you a happy birthday.
Did you know?
Just another one of Duck Detective's great deductions.
Huh? Anyway, that was really nice of you. No one else remembered. Can you believe it?
I can't believe it.
If you know my birthday, You must have a connection to someone here. Here's the key card to the office.
Thank you. Which way do I go, though? This way? Does this take me outside?
I don't know.
Oh, look at all the people in here. We're going to be making some deductions now.
Some peeling wallpaper exuded a stench of stale coffee and abandoned dreams. I knew I couldn't stay long, or it would rub off on me.
There's a lot of angry people here.
The register needs to be fired!
I'll see what I can do. Who are you?
I'm Sophie's friend.
Do you have a problem? If you have one, just call our hotline.
Oh boy.
I'm Eugene McQuacklin, detective.
I love it.
A client hired me to investigate a case.
Why didn't you just say so? It's time we put an end to the awful lunch death.
I agree.
All we need to fire him is some evidence from the upper management. I'll be in my office.
Okay.
First, I had to find out who works here and what their jobs are. I needed to find my client as well. Thankfully, I remembered the piece of paper I had in my jacket from taking notes during the call.
Well, I know this is Sophie. The giraffe works as a... Okay, don't have that one. The bear is a... Don't have that one. He is the... Okay, so we're going to need a few more clues here. I know that's lunch. Was stolen by a coworker known as... Don't know that one yet. All right, let's find a few more clues. Tricky deductions might require new perspectives. Press H to get additional guidance at any time. All right, so we got some hints if we need them.
It's a list of all the bus drivers.
Oh, that'll be helpful.
The most busy driver out of all four seems to be Petrovich.
Okay. Should we just keep going in here? Don't mind me, I'm just looking through your bag. Ooh. Let me see what it says here. Cash payment to Mr. Brandenburg, 30W, extra pepper salami. Ooh. It's me, Mario. Ooh, there's my salami. High quality, only the best. Is there gonna be a name tag on this bag somewhere? Zipper, there should be something else. Oh, there it is. Okay, pristine bag.
That's a lot of salami.
Hey, don't judge a person's salami. We're not salami judges here. I can inspect him? Oh yeah, that's right. Thick glasses. Bad eyesight. Same. I got bad eyesight too. Nothing in your teeth, that's good. Laura? Uh-oh, you've got Laura's mug. You don't look like Laura. Velcro shoes, lame. Oh no, he's a nerd.
I'm the only one here in the operating office. Can you imagine?
Nope.
I plan all the bus routes and make sure the buses are on time.
Okay, good for you.
Isn't that so cool?
Sure is.
Don't you have an angry customer shouting outside about the buses being late?
Yep, you do.
Really?
Oh, a key?
Do you have any idea who picked me to investigate?
No idea, but I'm so happy you're here.
I don't think you are.
I have a copy of your book. The early bird catches the criminal.
Oh.
Can you sign it?
Yes, I can.
I guess so.
That's all right. You got to take care of a fan.
Woo!
This guy's a little sketch, but I like him.
Thanks so much, Mr. Duck Detective. I won't ever forget this. This will become a core memory.
Okay, I don't have anything else to ask him, though. Right?
Oh, hello. How are you, Mr. Duck?
Duck Detective. All right, let's look around a little bit more. Hollandaise. Hollandaise goes to escargot. And then from escargot, you can either go to Brazil. Or, how do they pronounce that? Cilicia? That's all we got here.
Their buses don't go very far.
Okay. Sure, that'll be important here in a second. Oh, I just keep like kicking stuff over.
The two desks on this side look unused.
Lack of employees. That's interesting. I can't investigate those. Let's not go in there yet. We've got desk over here. I just kick over every trash can. Whitlock. Okay. Oh, password hint. Me and sexy aliens, what?
I wonder if there are clues to her password. I don't think I have enough information to crack it yet.
Not yet. So let's go talk to her. Let's take a look first. And nice, she buys her own headset. Lack of sleep? Yep, been there. Ooh, energy drink. Bad habits. Sometimes you just gotta do what you gotta do.
This is the third time you're calling. I'm telling you, your ex-wife did not cancel your booking.
She looks busy.
Yeah, let's might not want to bother her too much.
I need to ask you some questions.
No, I'm sorry. You can't take your 12 trombones on the bus.
Aw, what if I pay extra?
What? Can't you see I'm talking to a customer? It's company policy. Nothing I can do.
Okay.
Goodbye.
Do you know anything about who called me here?
What are you talking about? Listen, I have a million more emails to answer, and there are 50 people in the phone queue.
Aw, she is definitely overworked.
I have worked 10 days in a row, including 3 night shifts.
Whoa.
And Manfred still doesn't want to give me a raise.
Aw.
Just leave me at peace.
So, you have no clues for me?
It might be time to back away slowly. Eugene! Let's see if we can ask about Sophie, though.
What is your relationship with Sophie Windheimer?
Excuse me for a second. Oh, man, I don't know how I'd survive the office without her.
Well, that's good.
Sucks that she's at the reception.
Yeah.
I would have loved to have her in the office. I'm back. Yes, please collect your toddler from the bus station.
Yes, please. Okay. That's all we have to ask her about for now. Let's see if we can get Sophie finished off here. She's the receptionist. I don't have that one yet. Let's look at the client, the suspects, the client. I don't know who hired me yet. And I don't know who stole the lunch. Can we, Manfred, Rufus. I already forget who these people are. Uh-oh. Whitlock was the lamb. Petrovich was one of the bus drivers. This is probably Manfred, right? He's the one who has to give the raise. But I'm not sure yet. So I can come back in here and look at these things too. That's good. Okay. And then the locations. Okay, let's walk up this way a little bit. Let's look at this. Employee of the month.
It's a kitty cat.
Insert photo. Okay. Aw, Freddy sucks. Rufus Sedaris. Sedaris? Rufus? Whoever he is, he's the employee of the month. Stop with the post-its. Oh. Okay, so we got some new clues.
I'm not sure I'd feel particularly appreciated.
Should we go in here? Is this another office? Or is this outside?
Seem to promise well-kept secrets and rumors.
Let's take a look at him first. Oh, he's angry.
He's an angry bear.
Titac. Branch manager. Doesn't have a name. Oop. Messy. Oh, family man. Okay, I know a little bit about him. Let's ask him some questions.
How are the detective things going, Mr. Detective?
It's Mr. McQuacklin.
Right. Apologies.
McQuacklin. Eugene McQuacklin.
Are you planning on staying in my office much longer?
Yes.
I'll have to inspect the entire premise to do my job correctly.
Well, hurry up.
Was it you who called me?
No.
Yeah.
I never heard of you before.
Didn't think so, but I had to ask.
That's unusual.
It's good you're here, since there has been some unrest.
Uh-oh. That's all I needed to ask you about. Hey, look at all your stuff.
What a fancy nameplate. It says Ernst.
Ernst. So his name is Ernst. And what was his last name? I don't know his last name yet, do I?
It's a letter for an application for a promotion to senior customer service agent.
Okay.
Signed by L. Ernst.
Okay. Let's look at his little family here. Okay. You have a lovely wife. Oh, cute baby. Oh, twins. Bless your heart. Oh, what's hiding back there?
Is it normal to have a huge painting of your family in your office?
It's not normal.
What are you doing with my family's portrait?
Just looking.
Sorry.
Uh, Alright, I think we did everything in here, it looks like. Let's see if we can answer a few more clues, maybe? His name was Ernst. That's not even in here. There we go. Was it Freddy? No? Was it Manfred? There we go. Okay. And then I think this is Laura. Angst. She's customer service. Is this Freddy? Freddy Frederson? Okay. All right, so we've got a few more things done here. I still don't know who hired me, though. I would venture to say if Freddy stole the mug from Laura, I probably stole the sandwich as well, the lunch. But let's not jump to any conclusions too soon. Let's keep looking around. We haven't been in the kitchen yet.
In here must be the crime scene.
Yes. The scene of the crime.
First, I want to find out who the people in the office are.
I mean, didn't we do that?
It will make things easier in the long run. I'll need to remember to write everything down in my deductions.
Okay. Did I not do that? Oh. The bear is... who was it? Manfred? And he is the branch manager. I don't remember a cat. Was Laura the cat? Laura looks like a dog. Customer service? The crocodile is called Freddy. He works in the operating office. Okay.
Now that I had worked out these names, I was ready to check out the crime scene. Let's see where that lunch got stolen from.
I genuinely thought Laura was like a pug.
Then I could finally talk to my client.
I mean, I guess it's a cat. It looks like a pug to me. Sorry, Laura.
As soon as I entered the kitchen, the comforting waft of cheap white toast entered my nostrils.
Oh no, he has a bread addiction.
I knew I had to stay strong.
Come on, Eugene.
This wasn't what I was here for.
Think of Anna.
Stop eating the icing. Can't you wait a couple hours?
Margaret, if it wasn't for these pants almost bursting, I'd have this for breakfast every day.
Okay, Margaret Whitlock.
Yes, yes. And you can have it and so much more later when we're done preparing.
It kind of annoys me that we knock over every trash can. Halloween party. Spooky. Oh, canceled. Huh, what a bummer. Hungry? Get your own lunch. Looking for editor. Unpaid.
Office parties are a bad idea anyway.
They are kind of annoying.
They stopped doing them at the precinct after the jam. Incident.
Uh-oh. She put too much jam in the in the gun barrels. What'd you do? Hello, lady. Impeccable hair. She's been baking. If she's like the chef, why does she have a computer? Divorced. Oh, I see. I see.
Yes, dear?
I'm Eugene McQuacklin, detective, and I need to ask some questions.
Yes, indeed.
A detective? How exciting! What's the most gruesome murder you've seen?
That's... yikes.
How many dead bodies have you encountered?
Whoa. Teething turtles. You know what? Let's do it. Five little pigs.
No one died, but... I investigated a case once where five little pigs robbed a bank.
Oh.
Caught them red-handed. And got... they called it the piggy bank case.
Did someone get shot?
Oh.
What? No!
She seems like she's really into the macabre.
Beaten up?
No.
I don't know about you, honey.
Surely you must have some interesting stories.
Did you hear the one about the teething turtles?
I almost died that one time when I got myself into trouble with the teething turtles mafia.
Oh, mafia.
That incident taught me to stay away from beautiful ladies in red.
Yep, trouble every time.
Did they break your kneecaps?
Huh?
I mean...
No! You can see that I can walk just fine.
I was gonna say that. All right, let's ask you a few questions if we can.
Do you know anyone here who could have hired me?
To be honest, everyone was quite shocked by the lunch theft.
Yeah, sure they were.
And no one told me they've called a detective. I don't know what's going on at all.
Take a breath.
What do you think of Sophie Windheimer?
Did you know today's her birthday?
She doesn't have the easiest life, you know. She just had a terrible breakup with her ex.
Oh.
But don't tell anyone.
No problem. I'm a professional.
Can you tell me anything about Laura Angst?
Oh, she's such a hardworking girl.
Yeah, she is.
I heard she secretly studies for her online bachelor's during work.
Wow.
You need to keep this a secret, though.
I mean, you're telling me to keep everything a secret, but you're just like... Chatty Cathy over here. Let's take a look at this stuff here.
Gross.
Gross.
I doubt they washed their hands after leaving that greasy handprint.
Can we take a print? Margaret? Just got some lunch in here. Thanks for the food, Salami Bandit. Sharp claws. Kind of looks like Freddy's. It's the sandwich in question. What are we missing? Oh. All right.
So, this must be the crime scene.
Indeed.
This note is curious.
Quite curious. Here to fix the fridge. Janitor. Sci-fi. Practical. All right, kind of like this guy. Let's ask him some questions.
Dishwasher's broken again.
Not again.
What's wrong with these youngsters?
They probably stuffed some salami in there.
Don't know how to treat things with respect. Why would they put the mugs in face up?
Ugh. That's a pet peeve. Now you've made me angry.
I'm a private detective. I'm here to investigate a case.
Is that so?
It is so.
I need to find my client. Do you know who it could be?
Freddy's a bit of a weird one, so I'd imagine he would call detective.
You know what? That may be true, because he wanted me to sign the book, and he seemed to be a fan, so maybe he didn't. Maybe he stole the sandwich and then called me here just so he could meet me.
Personally, I feel we're doing just fine. And don't need no messing about our business around here.
Or maybe The penguin, the janitor, is the thief because he doesn't want me here. Curious.
Do you get along with Manfred Ernst?
He's a stubborn one.
I mean, he's the boss. He has to be.
I do respect that.
Yeah, he's just doing his job.
Would you say you enjoy Freddy Fredderson's company?
He's a bit of a weird one.
Huh. If anyone needs to learn to respect their elders, it's that moron.
Oh, boy. All right. So we've kind of looked around here everywhere. I wonder, since we've met more people, if we need to talk to people again and get their opinions on everyone else. We didn't go in there. Let's see if we can get in the computer again, though. I don't know that I can. Not that. This.
The PC is on, but the person who works at this desk seems to be on a break.
I mean, she's not on a break. She's in the kitchen making dessert.
They only have a single person answering the hotline right now?
Yeah, bless her heart.
That's surprising.
All right. So we can add a few more things in here. I still think it might be Freddy. Maybe not. So this is Margaret. Whitlock. This is... I don't think this is Rufus, but we'll try it. Oh, it is. Okay, so then the only thing we have left is just the bus driver outside. Let's just go ahead and finish that off then.
What kind of sorry soul was standing all alone in the rain?
Let's just knock them all over. Done. My job is complete. Can't look at this board. Hello, sir. He's a handsome guy. Hands in pockets, oh, bad manners. Handsome, bad manners. Boris.
Hey, man, this isn't the bus stop. You'll have to walk south to the central bus station.
I gotcha.
What? I'm not here to take a bus.
Yet. Until I need to go see Anna.
I'm investigating a case here at Bear Bus.
Oh, do you mean the lunch that got stolen?
Is it yours?
Exactly. You know?
Nah, too busy minding my own business. I don't talk much with the customer service folks.
Oh. So he didn't call.
What do you think of Sophie Windheimer?
Man, I wish she'd let me talk to her.
He's got a crush.
Do you, like Freddy Fredderson?
Or is Boris her ex? Did they just go through the breakup? I'm putting it together.
He's a pretty funny dude.
Yeah.
Loves to rant about detective novels.
That guy, I don't know about that. All right.
What do you know about Rufus Sedaris?
Employee of the month.
I don't think he likes me very much, to be honest.
He doesn't seem to like anybody.
But then, doesn't feel like he likes anyone at this office.
Exactly.
Except for Margaret, I guess.
Oh.
Do you think they have a thing going on?
I don't know. Should we ask?
I don't work here.
I thought you were a detective.
Someone left their bag here.
Uh-oh.
Ugh. suitcase full of dirty gym clothes.
Yeah. All right. Duffel bag is a new case. All right, we can go back inside, right? Let's finish off Boris here. All right. So we've got everyone listed here. I still don't know who hired me. I think Freddy. And I think it was Rufus. Okay. It's not. I wonder if I can get back in and look behind the vault. Or behind the picture at the vault. You can ask a few more questions now. Yeah?
Can you tell me more about Freddy Fredderson?
Let me put you on hold while I find the route for you. Freddy? Oh. He gets paid more than me. Can you imagine that?
No.
What an incompetent waste of office space.
Oh, boy.
This is Laura again. I checked the bus routes and found that.
What do you think about Manfred Ernst?
Oh, he's a great guy. I just wish I'd finally get a raise. Yes, yeah, sorry. This is Bear Bus. Your bus will be 3 hours late.
Oh, no.
The two desks on this side look unused.
Still nothing to do there. Let's go talk to Freddy again.
Can you tell me about Margaret Whitlock?
She gets really angry with me when I don't return mugs to the kitchen.
Why don't you just return them?
I do!
And you've got four on your desk.
Just not every day.
What do you know about Manfred Ernst?
I think he likes me.
Yeah,
he's
everybody likes you.
He's the only one who doesn't shout at me.
Do you get along with Boris Petrovich?
He's a chill guy.
Yeah.
I take the bus sometimes to go to bouldering conventions, and then we get to chat.
Oh.
Is this your bag?
Huh? No, mine's over there.
The one with all the salami?
Yeah.
Why do you need so much salami?
Yeah.
It's not mine. It was just there.
What?
A really nice surprise.
Huh. I think we can go back out and talk to Sophie again. Maybe she has some more information to give us. Yeah.
So, do you have an idea who would have hired me?
It's about the incident, isn't it?
Yep.
Sorry. No idea.
What can you tell me about Laura Angst?
Laura needs to chill out.
No.
I do love her, but if she keeps living like this, she'll have a heart attack by 23.
You gotta take care of yourself.
What kind of a person is Boris Petrovich?
Ugh. I don't know what I saw in him.
He is the ex.
I mean, I guess he's good looking, but... my God, is he boring?
Oh, poor Boris.
How are you getting on with Margaret Whitlock?
She's sweet and all, but...
a little bit overbearing.
She can't keep her mouth shut.
Yeah.
It seems like the office knows more about my personal life than me.
Yeah, that's true. Did I go in here? I don't remember if I went in here.
It says...
oh, we did not go in here.
It's locked.
Oh. Bummer.
It says it's locked.
Okay. So I can't go in there. All right. Let's go back and talk to Manfred again. Maybe if I keep knocking those over, we'll find a key. Maybe the key is in the vault.
What can you tell me about Boris Petrovich?
He's not the most reliable worker.
I can tell.
But it's difficult finding replacements nowadays.
You're not wrong. What about Rufus?
What is Rufus Sedaris like?
Not the greatest janitor, but he came with the building.
Oh. Okay.
What do you know about Laura Angst?
You gonna give her a raise?
Oh, she's a fantastic employee.
Yeah.
She basically does the work of five people.
Yep. That's it? Nothing?
What can you tell me about Bort?
He's... But it's different.
I don't know if there's anything else to do with these.
That's it. It's a letter for an application signed by...
What are you doing with my friend?
Sorry.
I'm gonna have to get him out of here at some point. Okay, so this is what I needed to finish here. It was Margaret is the sheep, works in customer service. The penguin is Rufus, and he's the janitor. Boris, the buffalo, is a bus driver. What? Oh, not Manfred. Margaret.
Now that I had everyone's name and job, it would be easier to figure out what was going on.
Is it? Two or fewer. So maybe Rufus and Freddy? Let's go back and talk to Boris again. Actually, let's go in the kitchen again. I don't want to use the hints yet. But I think we can talk to everybody a couple more times. I mean, I think Freddy's the one who stole the sandwich.
Do you know whose bag this is?
Isn't that Freddy's?
No.
Are you getting along with Rufus Sedaris?
He's standing right next to you, so be careful what you say.
You know, the two of us are from the older generation.
Oh, did you come with the building too?
Which means we understand each other well.
Okay.
He is quite harsh towards the younger ones, though.
I mean, that happens as you get older. You just don't have the patience you used to.
Do you know anything about this bag?
Why are you going around pushing bags into people's faces? Ugh, what's that awful smell?
Salami.
It's,
Oh. Oops.
What is your relationship with Margaret Whitlock?
Ah, she's a true sweetheart.
Yeah.
We have our weekly mahjong evenings.
Oh, is that what they're calling it nowadays? Let's go talk to Boris again. He might have something else now. We're just kind of going in circles here, but... That's all right. We should be able to get into Margaret's computer at some point, too.
Do you know anything about this bag?
Oh, it's really strange.
Yeah?
Things in it disappeared.
What?
And others appeared.
What?
Very suspicious.
So are you saying this is Freddy's and... he took the wrong bag out of the bus?
What are you even talking about? Is this your bag?
No.
Everyone here is being really unhelpful.
Okay. Back to either Laura or Freddy. Let's check out Laura's first. I don't think we can get in the computer yet.
The PC is on, but they only have a single person. That's a problem.
Nothing else from her. Let's go back to Freddy. Nothing from him. I mean, I think we've looked at all the clues. The only thing we haven't really done is get into the server room. Sophie, do you have anything for me? No? Okay. The only one I have left then is just Manfred. Anything for you? No. All right, so let's just see if we can get this. I think the one who stole it was Freddy. Bear bus is a good answer. Freddy called me about himself. Laura, Manfred, Margaret, the Salami Bandit. It's that Laura. Oh.
So it was Laura who called me.
I was gonna say Laura called because Freddy stole her mug, but this works.
I needed to discuss the case with her.
Why would she say she didn't call you?
You're my client? Why didn't you tell me?
Can I put you on hold for a second? What? Well, you should have told me. You're the duck detective.
We've just had a failure to communicate here.
What are you? I'm a duck. I'm wearing a trench coat.
Yeah.
So, is Freddy getting fired or what?
I'm working on it.
I'm working on getting him fired. Don't worry.
Ugh. It can't be that hard.
Kinda.
Sorry, I'm back. Yes, let me walk you through the booking process.
It was time that I found out what happened with the lunch theft and what they were planning in the kitchen.
Oh. Okay. I would like to say that Margaret is planning a surprise party. Oh, birthday party. For Sophie. Got it. Didn't even need to ask any questions.
Margaret
Boom.
Was planning a surprise birthday party for Sophie.
I probably should have went in there and asked. It would have been a little bit more dialogue.
I see. They didn't actually forget her birthday.
Yeah, let me come in here and see if we can get a little info out of her just in case, but I think since we solved it without asking any questions, we probably missed some dialogue.
Surely you must have some interesting stories.
That's
an inappropriate question. Maybe they didn't have anything else.
Their hands up.
All right, then what else did you have since we already solved all of those? The culprit. Interesting. We can probably we can probably solve that as it is, but let's go over here and see if Manfred has anything else. Nope. Sophie, guess what? They're gonna give you a surprise party.
Such a small office needs a reception. I'm just here to keep the angry customers out.
That's a sucky job. Yeah, I mean, we've got all the clues. I think we're ready to solve it, but I just want to make sure that I'm not missing anything else from anybody.
It's raining.
Boris!
Oh, it's cold out, but if I go inside, I have to face Sophie.
You gotta do it sometime, bud. I know Margaret doesn't have anything else. Let me check with Rufus. Yeah.
That'll teach them a lesson.
That will. They'll learn then to flip the mugs around the other way. Manfred! Manny! Hey, Manny!
You're still here.
Yes.
I have a feeling you're not enjoying my company. Not particularly.
I mean, you can leave. I really want to look what's behind the picture. Lara, guess what?
It was time that I found out what happened and what they were.
Freddy! All right. So I think we've done all that we can do. Let's go ahead and try to figure this one out. Freddy is being... Oh, somebody's being framed by Rufus because... Wrong bag. Boris is being framed by Freddy.
Detective work isn't easy.
Let's ponder the details.
Me in particular was to figure out the situation about the culprit. I had to consider. I was wondering who was involved in this business. I had to consider that not all identities were known yet. I was sure they'd come to light at a later point. I needed to work out what Fredderson has to do with all this.
Yeah. I mean, I already knew that part. Because I think Freddy picked up the wrong bag. Okay, let me think here. So I think Freddy's being framed. Freddy picked up the wrong bag. But who's he being framed by? Bearbus? Boris? Not Laura. She's the one who called. Manfred? Maybe if he was looking for a way to fire him. Margaret? Maybe. Rufus doesn't like anybody. Sophie? The Salami Oh. There it is. Salami Bandits framing him.
It was as I thought. Freddy Fredderson was actually being framed.
Okay, now what?
This office wasn't as boring as it looked.
No, of course not.
When Freddy took the bus back, and he went to pick up his luggage,
He grabbed the wrong bag.
He must have picked up the wrong bag. This happened because there was another bag that's identical to his.
Right.
The bag that he picked up belonged to the Salami Bandit. This made him a target. And to get rid of Freddy, the Salami Bandit decided to frame him.
Ooh.
Everyone, it's time for You Know What?
Drama.
Okay, get into position.
Do I get to yell surprise too?
I just texted her, so she should be here in a...
What's this?
Surprise! Oh, surprise!
No way.
Sophie!
This is all for me?
Yeah, dude. Nope.
Huh? A letter?
You get Salami. Happy birthday. Oh, no. Oh, no.
Salami? What a terrible present.
No, you silly idiot. The real present got stolen and switched for Salami.
Not again.
It's the Salami Bandit.
He's back.
I saw an awful lot of high-grade salami in Fredrickson's bag.
Yeah, Freddy.
And now there's no question who the perpetrator is. I've been telling you all along, we can't trust Fredrickson.
He's blind as a bat.
By the end of the day, he'll be fired. Mark my words.
Wow, Laura. You got an axe to grind.
Seems like a bit of an overreaction to a present being stolen. Or is there more to it?
The presents. Sophie received the following presents from her colleagues. Oh, I have to find out who gave her what. Okay. Let's go ask some questions. Sophie, are you okay?
It'll be okay. You have the duck detective here to figure everything out.
Every time they say duck detective, it just reminds me of Darkwing Duck. Have y'all seen that cartoon? It was on Disney Plus for a while. I love that cartoon.
What can you possibly do? Leave me alone.
It's gonna be okay. Already got that. Margaret? So I guess there's nothing new to find on these people. We've already found everything.
That's not nice at all. Who messes with someone's birthday?
True. Some people are just like that. Are you guys going to tell me what you gave her?
Do you think she liked my present?
Are you the one that gave the salami?
I mean, now she's crying, but I think I saw a sparkle in her eyes when she opened mine.
Okay, so it was the cat?
I should really get back to work.
Yeah, you got 50 people on hold. All right, let's take a peek here.
It's a heart-shaped necklace.
That's from Boris.
Looks tacky. Someone gifted Sophie a plushie.
I think that's probably from Laura.
It says limited edition.
Oh, ooh. This is from Margaret. Author? Okay. Should I read this? We'll read it when we find the last clue. Hang on. 252 pages. Holy smokes. Margaret.
Oh, God. What did I just read?
I don't know. I want to read it. Hang on. Let's look at the salami. Buongiorno, everyone. Quite unbelievable. I entered the office really easily. LOL. Sayonara, Eshlords?
Oh.
Salami Bandit.
I wonder what the purpose of that letter is.
Somebody's up to no good. Let's look at this. Hang on, I gotta see this. Where was it? This. Captain Brightbeak stared deep into the aliens' eyes. There were 12 of them, and they were red. The eyes, not the aliens. The aliens were blue, and there were 43. All of them wore shiny metal armor, which shined like something shiny made of curved metal. The lead alien stepped forward. Captain Brightbeak could tell it was the lead alien because it was the one which stepped forward. It was also the most beautiful, the only one with purple eyes. It made a noise that sounded a bit like talking from a hole that looked a bit like a pretty lady's mouth. The translation device the captain had invented word into action, translating the words into words he could understand. "Hey, you look cute," a mechanical voice whispered into his ear. "Can I get your number?" Woo! I wonder what else was gonna happen there. I need to know more. The plushie was from Laura. The book was from Margaret, obviously. I think Boris gave the necklace and... bag got stolen? Book, letters, necklace, nothing, plushies, okay. Maybe Laura did the necklace and Boris did the plushie. Oh, three things are wrong. So Laura did the plushie. I know Margaret did the book. Maybe Freddy did the necklace. Manfred, three things must be wrong. I still have three things wrong. The bag's gotta be wrong. So Laura did the necklace, nope. Margaret, nope. Rufus, maybe. Horace. Freddy. Hang on, let's go talk to some more people. We still have another clue as well. Rufus, what did you do?
So, what happens to the cake now?
Well, after she's done crying, maybe we can eat it.
Think about this letter.
People don't know how to write letters by hand anymore. What's with the weird line breaks?
Yeah, true. Okay, so can I talk to everybody else about the letter too? Freddy, what did you do?
They really think I've done it.
Yep.
Dr. Detective, you have to help me.
Why?
You know it wasn't me, right?
You have the bag.
Did you not think it was strange that your bag was full of salami?
I don't know. I thought someone gave me a salami surprise. I'll eat salami sandwiches for breakfast, lunch, and dinner from now on.
Indeed you will.
Two desks on this side.
Still nothing here. I can get in here.
I knew it.
Cracked it.
She's the lead.
Let's see what secret she has on her computer.
Yeah. Cutie. Secret cake recipe. Never gonna give you a- Oh, she's Rickrolling people. Dang it, Margaret. She's going on vacation. Are you taking one of your own buses? Oh, who's this from? Delete everything. Oh no.
Who is this person she's messaging?
They're in cahoots. Manny, I got something to tell you.
I'm guessing you're ready to present legal evidence of Frederson's misconducts.
Nope.
It wasn't Frederson.
Everything is pointing towards him.
It's a frame job.
I will present the true culprit soon enough.
Well, I don't really care how long it takes you. This will be Frederson's last day.
Do you know anything about this letter?
Well, it's obviously a cheap prank by Frederson.
No.
Only he would find this funny.
No. I'm sorry, sir, but you have it perfectly wrong. Boris, I've got to talk to you. What did you do to Sophie? Customs procedures for passengers entering from the west border. Allowed goods, personal items worth less than 500 schmark. Notify the local police of suspicious activity. Prohibited goods, weapons. 10 trombones, prohibited. Meat, plants. Books not in the interest of the eastern states. Potatoes. Luggage will be checked at the bus station. For more information, visit brezel.de.customs.
What do they have against potatoes?
Yeah, and trombones.
Maybe it was too romantic.
You did the necklace.
Did Sophie ask about me?
Yes.
She might have mentioned you.
She actually didn't, but I just want to make you feel better.
Did she really? I bet my present will blow her away.
Oh, was it a gun or was it 10 trombones? Nothing here. Can we go back out front? Is this koala the, the culprit? I mean,
it says it's locked.
Still locked.
I can't leave now.
I can't.
I need to solve the case.
I can't leave now. I wanted to go talk to the koala again, the protester. All right, let's talk to people one more time. Make sure I did all this.
Do you think she? I should really get back.
What about the letter?
Can you tell me something about this letter?
Sophie won't even talk to me about it. I don't know what to do.
Okay. This one we did. You don't have anything to say about the letter. Margaret, I was at your desk.
That's not nice at all. Who messes with someone?
Saw some things I didn't want to see on there. Okay. So, Rufus gave the book. Interesting.
So, nothing got stolen after all. It seemed that the salami present was intentional.
Yep. Who would do such a thing? Laura? No, Margaret. Margaret's the one who didn't give any gifts. Sophie received a... scary letter that contained a... received a
Sophie
silly letter.
Was receiving threats.
Well, it was silly.
I needed to find out why.
Who would want to hurt Sophie? She's the sweetest giraffe in the world.
That's not nice at all. Who messes with...
Okay, Sophie, we need to talk. We still have to do this. Let's see. Salamis are being illegally imported from Cilicia.
Explains all the high-grade salami.
Yes, it does.
I just needed to find out who was behind this.
Yes.
The mystery of the salami bandit was slowly getting unraveled. Western goods are prohibited from entering and being sold in the East.
Okay.
This is why the salami bandit decided to make a business out of buying high-grade salami in the West.
Ooh.
Smuggling it to the East. And selling it at a high profit.
It's all about that money laundering.
Also, for some reason, Sophie received a letter from the salami bandit.
Oh.
That had a hidden, threatening message.
Be quiet, or else.
This was serious. I had to question all of the employees.
Be quiet or else.
Thanks for coming, everyone. Well, everyone except for Sophie.
Sophie? Is Sophie threatening herself?
Where is she?
Oh, she's not here. Uh-oh.
Slacking off, playing on her computer phone like usual.
Are you sure, or did somebody pop her off?
She's having problems with her family. She was at her desk and said she needed a moment.
I will start then regardless. I have made my deductions and drawn some serious conclusions.
I think somebody should check and make sure Sophie's okay. Nope.
Who is the murderer?
Murderer?
I... What? No one died.
Sophie, are you okay?
I'm getting framed, I'm telling you.
What a load of baloney.
No, it's Salami.
He is right, actually. He is getting framed.
He is getting framed, but it's Salami, not baloney.
What? Why would anyone bother?
Ah, that is the question, isn't it? Why would anyone bother?
Get to the point.
Oh boy.
It's through my observations that I uncovered.
Here comes.
Conspiracy.
This is ridiculous.
Uh-oh.
Why are we still listening to a random doctor waddle into this office?
Uh-oh.
I'm leaving.
No, you're not.
I'm a certified private investigator and...
It's okay. Just tell us what you know.
Salami is being smuggled from Salsicia. Using your very own buses.
Huh? Boris?
What's going on?
Okay, this is going too far. I really have more important things to do.
Manfred?
Now that is really scandalous. Does that mean we're losing our jobs?
Maybe.
Probably. Oh, they're dropping like flies.
Listen, everybody. It's really important that no one leaves the premises.
Eugene.
I need to get back to work.
Come on, McQuacklin, step up.
Everybody's leaving.
Well, this isn't going well.
I'm still here. Mr. Duck Detective?
So is he the only one that's not involved and everyone else is?
Yeah.
That'd be hilarious. Freddy's the only good guy. Alright, so what do we need to do here? Fred, my man!
This is getting intense, isn't it?
Well, that was chaos.
Maybe you could need a little help? You seem lonely.
Oh.
I could be your assistant.
No, I don't think so.
What do you want me to do? Decipher messages? Talk someone into telling us the truth? Follow people around?
Yeah, because you're not obvious.
I'm pretty good at that.
Just stay here.
Like this?
Yep, just...
You're doing good.
Just like that, yeah. I'm having so much fun with this. All right, let's go talk to these little brats again who all stormed out on me. I need to go check on Sophie first. I'm not talking to any of these people yet till I see Sophie. Where is she?
It says server room. It's locked.
Oh, I need to see her.
Sophie left.
No.
And she left a note on the desk.
Oh. That's it, I quit. You'll never see me again. Sophie.
What a dramatic turn. I should keep this as evidence.
Yeah. She even toppled her chair over on her way out. Yikes. Oh, she got an email. I'll tell them everything. Don't. You blocked this number. Click here to unblock. Oh. What's going on, Sophie? Oh, she's written an AITA. She's redditing. High expectations for a birthday card? I can't believe
she complained about this online.
Yeah, it's not really that bad. Ooh, what's this?
Let's see. The last dialed number on this phone is 03051777.
We should call that number. Nothing else in there. Nothing else in here. We didn't talk to Boris, did we? Boris?
She left? Just like this? Maybe she's at home. Should I look for her?
I mean, I think somebody probably should make sure she's okay.
Did you read Sophie's letter?
I did. Something's off. Something's different.
You're saying she didn't write it? Laura?
This this is the note Sophie left. Can you tell me more about it?
It doesn't make sense at all that she'd just suddenly leave. She definitely needs the money. Mm. And she would have told me. I'm her friend.
Well, kinda. I'm actually really worried about Sophie. This stuff we've already checked. Let's just double check.
It's a list of all the bus drivers, the most busy driver out of all four.
Just to make sure. Got that. Let's look at Freddy's desk. Uh-oh, he's into murder. Detective novel. Murder at the Beaver's Dam. When the dam broke, Beaver Michael lost his mind. Kidnappings. Okay, so he's into mysteries. Are these the ones that I wrote? A kidnapping and a kingpin. Never kidnap a king penguin. Kingpin on his birthday. Oh, he loves me. Eugene McQuacklin, duck detective. Thoroughbred to the fine beak of Lady Justice. 10,000 posts. Eugene, my guy. How long you been on here? Looking for a job will do almost anything. Buy my book.
Someone is clearly obsessed with detectives.
And just you. Shouldn't be anything on here. Let's double check it. That one's good. Still nothing here, right?
The two desks on this side.
Nope. Laura?
This folder says manual for CS agents.
Right.
How and when to create vouchers correctly.
It's just work instructions.
I'm falling asleep just reading the title.
Yeah, it's just standard. Standard procedures. Sophie? So they've been chatting back here. Oh. So she's got the alien thing too. What? What a den pen name. It's just his name backwards. Okay.
You definitely don't want to be Laura's enemy.
Okay. That's interesting. We checked Margaret's desk once. There's more? No. We already got it all. All right, Margaret. Maybe you can go work for a school lunch lady or something like that.
Oh, maybe I can be a real estate agent.
You could.
I always wanted to be a rich real estate agent.
What do you think of this note?
It's no surprise she's left, is it?
I mean, a little bit.
Would you want to work with someone you've dated in the past?
No. That's a valid point. Let me go outside real quick. There shouldn't be anybody out here unless Sophie's out here, but... Oh, Manfred's out here.
It's not really a detective's job to spin crazy conspiracy theories, is it?
You're acting a little shady.
Sometimes the truth is pretty crazy.
Yeah.
Seems a bit cheap.
Really?
Have you seen Sophie's resignation?
No. I can't say it comes as a surprise. She never particularly enjoyed her job. It's difficult finding replacements nowadays, though.
That's the second time you've said that. So you're replacing people often? There's nothing else out here. Doesn't look like it. All right, let's go in his office and see if we can look behind the picture now, since he's outside. Oh, Rufus is here. Rufus!
Why would Laura recruit you to deal with a theft?
Well?
Aren't there any other detectives who are actually qualified for the job?
Nope, just me.
I've been doing very well so far, if I do say so myself.
Yeah, so take that.
The truth will be revealed in the end.
Huh.
What do you think about this letter?
People don't know how to write.
What's with the weird line?
He's gonna come in here and catch me, isn't he? We already looked at those. Nothing over here.
Finally, Manfred is out of his office. Time to see what's behind his precious family portrait.
Let's do it. It's the key to the server room. What? What? Hang on. Is there numbers? What numbers go in here? I really don't know. CSOOB day. Find this.
Detective work isn't easy. I was sure I would be able to crack. Detective work isn't easy. The thing that bothered me in particular was
the safe.
That note on the safe had pairs of letters on it.
Yeah.
I wonder if they're abbreviations for something.
I mean, kind of.
Haven't I seen them before? I should also look at previous deductions. What could they mean, and what can I... Did I see any numbers around the office?
Okay, so CS, there were two empty desks. Let's try that. This is whatever Freddy is, the office, operating office, something like that. Hang on, let me see if he had anything. This... 210. No, that's not what I wanted to do. No, not that. Was there anything else? This four. That's the bus depot, though. Right? I'm still missing one object, too. That's probably what's in the safe. I don't know. I know this one's right and this one's right, so let's just try numbers in the middle here till we get it. That one. Oh, okay. That was pretty quick and painless.
Damn it. Oh, I always wanted to open a ridiculously big safe.
Me too. That would be so cool.
Let's see what secrets he has in here.
Yes, let's see. Two letters, different handwriting. Dear Ingrid, I know I haven't been there for you and the kids recently. Uh-oh. But things are looking up. I would love to take you to a romantic getaway to Hollandaise. Love, Manfred. Here's the keys that I need. Demands. Oh, no. Employee of the month. That's Rufus. TV in my room. Oh no. Keep quiet about the thing. Blackmail. Do all these things and nothing will happen to you. Ooh.
An awful lot of security for a branch manager of a bus company. Wait, this key. keychain.
Yep.
Here it is. The key for the server room.
What are we gonna find in there? What, do I have something ready to go? Receptionist. Sophie got... I hope she didn't get murdered. Because... wanted to snitch. I don't think any of this is right. Sophie got kidnapped because Sophie wanted to snitch. So she knew about the salami all along.
There must be more to this.
Oh boy, we gotta get in that server room. Rufus, I'm on a mission. Don't mind me, fellas, I'm just gonna come right in here.
Let's see what's hidden in here.
Doing?
Nothing.
Secret detective business.
Adios, amigos. Dark in here.
The electrical sparks and blinking lights created a claustrophobic atmosphere.
Yeah, you really shouldn't have sparks in your server room. That's not a good thing.
I definitely felt that I wasn't supposed to be here.
There's ghosts in this room.
What's he keeping in all these boxes? I don't think it's meant to do this.
No, it's not. Mirror, mirror on the wall. Breadcrumbs, oh no. Ah, poor Eugene.
Has that been there the whole day?
Yeah, brush yourself off. Make yourself look presentable. Ooh. Got a little CCTV action. Our IT person is computer literate. That's great.
What's up with these Bear Bus vouchers on eBay?
Yeah, she's got a little side hustle going on here. Of course, we gotta knock over the bottles.
Honestly, this is nicer than my apartment.
No, your apartment wasn't that bad. So, oh, this will be a big one here. Okay, so let's see here. We got blackmailed. Well, Manfred is getting blackmailed. Okay. So who's the one doing it, though? Bearbus, blackmailed. Somebody's blackmailing. I think it's Rufus or Margaret to make him, her, stay quiet about Bearbus illegally selling vouchers. Or it could be salamis too. Importing salamis. Blank is the one that provides the vouchers to, no, the salamis to somebody. To the salami bandit. No, the salami bandit is the one that provides them to Rufus. Three things. That's actually not too bad. Rufus, Margaret. Still wrong. Rufus is right. Three things are wrong. So when I did that before, it was three or more. So this is three. So Rufus is right. Vouchers. Okay, vouchers is correct. Salamis, vouchers. Vouchers is correct here as well. Salami bandit. Sophie. I think this one is wrong. So this one needs to be changed for sure. These two I'm pretty sure are good. So is this Rufus or is this Margaret? This is Rufus as well. Blackmailed I think is fine. Manfred I think is fine. No, not Margaret, Manfred. So I think Bearbus and the Salami Bandit are wrong about Rufus. There we go. Got it. Nice. Rufus is selling them.
This is what Rufus and Margaret were doing with the vouchers.
Margaret's getting them for him. Okay.
That might be illegal, but this wasn't what I was here for.
That's true.
I needed to catch the salami bandit.
We just want to know who's got that salama.
I quickly needed to find out where Sophie was being kept.
Yeah, poor Sophie.
I also couldn't let the salami bandit get away with this.
She got kidnapped on her birthday?
It was finally time to find out who was behind everything.
It's Boris. He wants to come in like a hero and save you. Sophie is at, well, it's got to be either Rufus or Margaret, right? No? Manfred's? No. Bearbus office. There we go.
Oh my god! That's where she is being kept!
She's on the bus.
It's important that I stayed calm now. I couldn't alert the culprit, or all of this will have been for nothing.
Who did it?
I needed to first figure out who is behind everything, so I could confront them.
I mean, I've got all the clues, so I should just be able to go, right? Okay, handwriting is identical. I mean, I want to say that it's Margaret because Rufus and Margaret. Okay, so who had identical handwriting? Wait, it's got to be Sophie's writing. Because she's the one who wrote the note. Margaret? Laura? Oh, good. Boris, Freddy, Manfred. Okay, so I've gone through everything except for the Salami Bandit. Oh, there it goes. Manfred is the Salami
Manfred
Bandit.
Manfred is the Salami Bandit. That makes a lot of sense.
Yep, it does.
Ironic that his handwritten note meant to frame Frederson ended up incriminating Manfred instead.
Yeah, he incriminated himself.
Something was missing here. Who else was involved with this? I had collected everything I needed. I just had to organize my thoughts.
Yes. Here we go. Accomplice? Because the Salami Bandit needed someone who could easily carry out the... selling of the vouchers. So it would be Margaret. Three things are wrong. Importing of the salamis. Okay, so who's the accomplice? Boris. Yep, he's the driver. That makes
sense.
Salami
Bandit wasn't working alone. It made sense for the bus driver to be involved.
Sure does. Oh. Infatuation. Oh, lover. Blank is the Salami Bandit's lover because she used to date Blank, and the Salami Bandit needed someone who could convince Blank into Blank. Into helping, could convince. I think it's Sophie. Sophie is the Salami Bandit's lover because he used to date Boris. And the Salami Bandit needs someone. Actually, let's change these. Let's go Boris. Used to date. Oh, no, he's not the lover. Sophie is. Could convince Boris into helping. Two or fewer things are wrong. So helping, oh, is this one actually wrong? Into snitching? Freddy? Laura? Oh, Sophie.
I couldn't believe Sophie managed to talk Boris into this. Aha! I had it all figured out now. It was time that I confront the culprits.
I mean, it's basically everybody except Freddy, just like we said.
But first, I had to free Sophie.
She's an accomplice.
Oh.
Oh, this place is a mess.
Why is everyone yelling?
This looks dramatic.
Yeah, it sure does.
It's kind of a long story.
We got time. Tell us, Sophie.
And guess who deduced said long story? The one and only Duck Detective.
Read the room.
This is how everything went down.
Here we go.
The Britzel Beerbus Branch was suffering losses and had their budget cut as a result. Manfred, worried about the financial stability of his family, felt himself backed into a corner.
Right, he's got twins to feed.
This is when he became the Salami Bandit.
No!
He laid his grand plan of salami smuggling and realized he couldn't do this alone. He recruited Boris, since it would be easiest for the bus driver
right.
to load and unload the wares discreetly. The bus would go through a customs check at the Salsiccia bus station first. And then Boris would take a detour to get the salami and load it onto the bus. This is why the buses always had a huge delay.
Right.
It wouldn't be easy to talk Boris into crime, so Manfred convinced Sophie to join the team. Boris's obsession with her would make it easy for her to manipulate him into helping with their plan. Everything was going well until the duck detective, that's me, infiltrated the office. Freddy was meant to be the scapegoat for the crime, but I'm not fooled that
Sophie
easily.
Just let us right in.
Sophie began getting cold feet and ultimately wanted to confess to the police.
Yep.
Manfred couldn't have this, so he interfered.
Manny.
In an outburst of panic, he abducted her and hid her in the luggage compartment of one of the buses. This is why...
What were you going to do with her?
Manfred stole Laura's lunch!
Oh, I completely forgot that's what we were looking for.
What?
Everything is figured out, but who is truly guilty? Manfred, Sophie, and Boris are all involved in the smuggling.
Wow.
Who should get arrested for their crimes? Manfred was the mastermind behind everything.
Right, and he's the owner, so that, or the, at least the manager. So usually it starts from the top down.
Should Manfred get arrested?
Yeah, yes.
He is the reason this all started in the first place.
Right.
Of course he should be arrested. What about Sophie?
Sophie technically didn't do anything illegal other than aiding in it, knowing about it.
Without her, the smuggling wouldn't have been possible.
I mean, she really just brought Boris on board.
She manipulated poor Boris into taking the salami across the border. Should Sophie get arrested?
No.
Manfred clearly was the one who gave the instructions.
Right.
Sophie was naive to follow along. But I don't believe she is truly liable.
Yeah, I mean, she knew about it, but I don't think you could really charge her for any crimes.
Boris was at the end of the chain.
He knew what he was doing.
Had he refused to take the salami on board, the plan would have not worked out.
Right.
Should Boris get arrested?
Yep.
He might have not realized what was going on entirely, but that doesn't mean he's not liable for engaging in the smuggling.
Ignorance is not an excuse.
All right. I've made up my mind. I will report to the state police...
that Manfred stole a sandwich.
Manfred! Boris!
And I do it again!
Aw, Manny.
Anything to secure my family's well-being.
Well, how well are they going to be now?
I'm not sure grand-scale salami smuggling was necessary for that.
How else was I going to cope with all the budget cuts? If anyone actually worked in this office...
Oh, that's a slap in the face to Laura for sure.
We wouldn't have such terrible performance in the first place!
Yeah.
Yes, and then you keep asking for promotions.
I mean...
how am I going to give anyone a promotion if we have people baking cakes during working hours?
That's true.
And while we're at it, Rufus!
Yeah.
How dare you embezzle money from the company? And then threaten me!
That's... Rufus said we're only doing that until his book takes off.
Uh-huh.
And then I'll play the lead alien in the movie adaptation.
No, he's gaslighting you.
Look who's going to jail now, Manfred.
I mean, if you're embezzling money, you're going to jail too, Rufus.
Not me, that's for sure.
I stand by what I said. I regret nothing.
The police? I didn't do anything.
You know very well you assisted in organized smuggling.
I didn't. I thought I was helping Sophie. She said her cousin was ill, and the only thing that would make her happy was the salsiccia salamis.
Mm.
But look at him. He's such a nice guy. I don't believe he could ever do something wrong.
He has, though.
Yeah.
Ignorance is no excuse.
I just said that. I just said that.
Wow, you really did quack the case, Mr. Duck Detective.
Yeah, I did. Good one.
You're just as cool as I imagined.
A
person. Oh, that's great.
The truth is an ugly mistress. It is my duty to throw bread to the fine beak of Lady Justice.
Yeah. Wow. I mean, yeah, Manfred's a given. Sophie, I'm surprised that many did. Boris, I think is pretty solid as well. I am surprised that many did decide to arrest Sophie. Very cool. That's why you're so poor.
Everybody already went home. How am I going to pay for the bus?
I think the bus station is going to be closed there, buddy.
Guess I'm walking home.
Oh.
Ahem. Need a ride?
Yes.
I just booked this one. It's been such a long day after all.
Yeah, we'll just do it.
Come on, it'll be fun! Plus, you must be tired after all the detective work.
I really don't.
Please?
Just do it. Although, you don't want them to know where you live.
Yeah, fine.
Great! Now I finally have time to tell you all about my ideas for your social media.
Oh no.
Please don't.
I could get you tons of publicity.
No.
You need the money.
And imagine, we can team up.
Absolutely not.
Yeah.
And I can be your sidekick.
Nope. That's great. All right, we need a sequel because I got to find out what happens with Anna. You could actually build a lot off of this, too. I mean, you could take this. He's a detective, so there are all kinds of crimes that he could investigate. So, yeah, there's definitely potential there for more games. That was awesome. That was a great game. I loved that. If you made it all the way to the end of the video, thank you so much for watching. You guys are the best. If you enjoyed it, leave a like on the video and also subscribe if you're new. Either way, I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.